welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, please take a moment to subscribe and hit the bell icon beside it to get notified whenever I upload a video. So this look is all about the classic black smoky eyes, which you can wear with literally everything. So let's jump into the world of makeup. I've exfoliated and moisturized my face already, so as always, I'm starting with my brows. Here I am using the Benefit Brow Pomade in the shade Dark Brown. If you guys want to see a detailed video on how to do your brows without making it look unreal, please comment below and let me know. After filling in my brows, now I will clean the border of my brows with a concealer which is 2 to 3 shades lighter than my skin tone. This will make the shape of my brows more prominent. Now I will bring the concealer onto my lids as this will act as my eyeshadow base. I will blend this with a damp beauty blender so that there is no excess product left. I will do my base makeup first and then come back to my eye makeup. So firstly, I am creating a sticky base on my skin by applying a good primer. This will also make my makeup long lasting. Here I am using an illuminating primer from Givenchy to get that extra glow. Now to color correct all the discoloration on my face, I am using an orange color corrector. This is Kryolan Derma in the number D34. You can already see the difference. You can use any orange color corrector of your choice. Just make sure that the orange color is not too dark, because it will be really hard to hide the orange color under your foundation if the color is too intense. Now to blend it well into my skin, I will use a damp beauty blender. By doing this, I will make sure that the orange corrector does not mix with my foundation, which is coming up next. For the foundation, I am using the Maybelline Fit Me foundation and I am in the shade 230. At first, I will apply the foundation all over my face in dots using my fingertip, and then I will use a damp beauty blender to blend it out. This beauty blender is from Makeup Revolution. What more can I say about this foundation? This is such a popular foundation. It's pocket friendly and gives a decent coverage. It's great for all skin types. It has a wide range of shades for every complexion. Now to highlight my face and to conceal the discoloration under my eyes further, I'm using a lighter shade concealer on the high planes of my face. This is the Maybelline Age Rewind Concealer in the shade Neutral. This is a holy grail product for me, as this concealer is crease proof, but it does not make my under eye area dry. I absolutely love this concealer. I will use the same damp beauty blender to blend it. Now to contour my face, I am applying this darker concealer in the hollows of my face. I will apply this on the usual contouring areas and again blend everything with a damp beauty blender. Just follow the direction in which I am blending. This will help me slim down my face up to a certain extent. If you want a detailed video on contouring and highlighting your face, please comment below and let me know. I will definitely make a separate video on contouring and highlight. to set my base, I'm using Maybelline Fit Me Loose powder in the shade light medium. I love to set my face using a damp beauty blender rather than a powder brush, because personally baking does not work for me. It makes my under eyes more dry and cakey. But if it works for you, this is the time. Don't apply too much powder to set your base, because that will make your foundation cakey gradually. So the trick is, less is more. Take little bit powder and press it against your skin so that it gets absorbed into the skin. This makes the makeup much more long lasting. Now to set and seal everything, I'm using the MAC Fix Plus setting spray. So coming back to my eye makeup, as I have not set my lid previously with any powder, the concealer has already creased. So first I will blend the concealer, set it with some powder before applying any shadow. Now I am using the Huda Beauty Rose Gold Remastered Palette. First I am dipping into Sandalwood for my transition. I love using colors closer to my skin tone as my transition shade, because that makes the eye makeup very put together. Now I am stamping the color Henna on my crease line. I am using a smaller blending brush to do so, as I am concentrating only on my crease line. Now I am painting my lid black up to my crease line. Here I am not using any base before applying the black color shadow, because this shadow is very much pigmented. But if you don't have such pigmented black shadow, just apply some gel liner or kajal all over your lid and then stamp the black eyeshadow over it to get this intense black smoky eyes. Now to merge the black and the brown together, I am blending my crease line with Henna once again. Now using a larger blending brush, I will soften everything. I will not take any more color. I will just blend the edges. Now I will smoke out my lower lash line as well with Henna first. Then I will apply the same black shadow on my lower lash line, but not too close to my waterline. Now I am highlighting my brow bone and inner corner with Moon Dust from the same palette. Now I am applying this nude eye pencil from Wet n Wild on my lower waterline. I will call it a day by applying some mascara on my upper and lower lashes and by applying some falsies off camera. I will now curl my lashes so that my own lashes merge with the falsies completely. Now coming back to my face, I will contour my face with a darker shade from MAC Studio Fix Powder Foundation. You can also use any bronzer instead of this, but I like to keep it matte, so I am using a contour powder. To highlight the high planes of face, I am using a lighter shade from MAC Studio Fix Powder Foundation. You can also use banana powder instead of this, but the Studio Fix powder gives a little bit of coverage, so I prefer this over the banana powder. I will go very light-handedly for blush. Now for highlighter, I will go with something very natural looking. I'm using the Mega Glow highlighter from Wet n Wild in the shade Precious Petals. This gives a really healthy and natural glow to your skin without making you look like a disco ball. Now for the last time I am applying this fixing spray so that everything gets locked and does not budge. For my lips today, I will outline it first and then apply the shade Chai from Nykaa Matte to Last Liquid Lipstick. So here is the completed look. Don't forget to hit the like button and share it with your friends. Please let me know your thoughts by commenting below. I've mentioned all the products in the description box below. Please check that out. My social media links are also provided in the description box. Thank you so much for watching. See you soon with a brand new video. Bye.